Hello, everyone. Welcome again to another Word for Today with Ray. And before we begin, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for your Word. It's so consistent daily to be able to come and to discover more about you and Jesus and your ways and the ways that you want us to be in this world. So today, Lord, I pray that you will teach us again by your Holy Spirit those things that you want us to know and the ways that you want us to be in this world. And may Jesus' name be glorified in all that we study and hear, and we'll give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. The title to today's lesson is Something, Nothing, Deceived. And it's taken from Galatians chapter 6 and verse 3. After addressing the theology of the church members in Galatia concerning living after the law for salvation versus living by grace, Paul the Apostle has been giving them instructions about how to live with one another. If someone fails, restore them. If someone has a burden, help them, and the like. In chapter 6 and verse 3 of Galatians, Paul gives a reason for this manner of living. He wrote, "For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceives himself." Paul begins with, "For if a man thinks himself to be something." Paul knows there is a deep-rooted desire within the Galatian church members to be something. There are people who believe themselves to be just a little bit better than others, and they project it in their behavior. They will not stoop to certain tasks, and they certainly will not go out of their way to help another person. They live on the excuse of inconvenience, and they desire that everyone know their station in life. Paul sets the person within this mindset in their place. He continued, "When he is nothing." There are people who hold prestigious positions in places of notoriety. However, there are also those who believe they reign in important places but actually don't. Sometimes there is nothing worse than being around a person who thinks themselves higher ranked but are no greater than anyone else around. Paul says, he deceives himself. In contrast to restoring one who has fallen and bearing one another's burdens, Paul shares about the person who is deceived. Sometimes people believe themselves to be too good to restore others, and it would be beneath them to serve others by bearing their burdens. However, the kingdom of God does not work in that manner. Jesus said in the Gospel of Mark in chapter 10 and verses 22 through 24, "You know that they which are accounted to rule over the Gentiles exercise lordship over them, and their great ones exercise authority upon them. But so shall it not be among you, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister, and whosoever of you will be the chiefest shall be the servant of all." In other words, the person who believes themselves to be something when they are not is deceived. And they do not practice the behavior of Jesus Christ, who is the Savior and Lord of all who believe in Him. Are we deceived into believing that we are something that we are not? Are we practicing behaviors that make us think we are better than others? And if the chance were afforded us, would we resist restoring them or helping them bear their burdens? Maybe we should take time after hearing this verse to meditate upon what it means to have self-righteous ideas about ourselves that are not truth. Next time we will see how we are to be about our own work. So read ahead and let us join together then. Until tomorrow, there is more. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May He make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace as you continue to study His Word in Jesus' name.